Whether you can take blogging as a career or not is really up to you. You need to assess where you are in life, what your responsibilities are, what your savings are. It's a tough job. I definitely do not make as much as I would have if I stayed on in my corporate career at this point. I wanted to be a food writer, and I'm talking of 4 or 5 years back, and it's still a developing sector. So it's not that I'm a journalist, I'm a food writer. I've come from market research, so why will people even take me seriously or give me a job? And what sort of job does one get in food writing? There was this increasing uncertainty, and you know, you're all conditioned. Like, I got a lot of support from my wife, who said that, you know, how many people want to go out and try to follow their dreams, and you're doing that. There are very accomplished bloggers and food writers who work to a schedule, and I admire them for that. In my case, I just sit and write, and I think that this consistency has worked for me. This desire to tell a story from my life has worked for me, because, you know, when it comes to food, there are various ways you can write about it. Like, a chef will write about the cooking technique, a farmer will write about sourcing, a journalist will write about the politics of food, a historian will write about the historical ramifications. They will probably do it way better than I would. But what no one can do is write my story the way I can, because no one else knows that, just as I won't know your story. So I always believe that if you write from your own voice, if you tell a story from your own voice, that is what will work. And you know, people who are cooking from their heart, but they don't really have money to invest in PR, they are not corporates, this, that. I want to seek out their story, because there's so much of heart, so much of love, so much of hard work which they put in their work. And the food is so good, and often so economical, you know, all of us sort of survive on that. So I wanted to share their stories from Mumbai, across India, across the country. You know, you're competing with so much noise out there. There's a lot more competition, there's fresh talent coming in. And it sometimes can be very intimidating, because you might be doing something out there and you see no response, and it might be very scary. All I would say is that be patient, be confident. I think some of the rules are evergreen, they don't really change. Be a storyteller, try to have your own unique voice, believe in what you're saying, be sincere, stick at it, and you will chart out your own success story. Through my writing, I can just bring in a moment of happiness to someone's life, a moment of joy, a moment of hope. If I can sort of calm the restlessness of someone for a second, and help them feel good about themselves, about their lives, I think that's a job well done.